it's time for the closing of Module 3. In this module, we had 3 objectives. In the first part, we talked about what are the forms of evidence-based practices that we're going to use within intensive intervention. In part 2, we talked about where do you locate different evidence-based practices. And then in part 3, we talked about how do you determine your instructional platform once you've identified those evidence-based practices to put into that platform. So let's check in with Mr. Flores.
Wow, I started using some of the different progress monitoring measures. Now I need to focus my attention on the instruction within DBI. Where do I find information about evidence-based interventions to address all the different needs of my students?
So it seems that we've answered Mr. Flores' question. So we talked about where can we find different evidence-based practices. And we also talked about once we identify those evidence-based practices, whether to understand whether those were an evidence-based intervention, an evidence-based strategy, or a promising practice. And remember, as we talked about in part 1, we do not want to use any practices that have no evidence or negative evidence. Because when we think about our DBI framework, we want to think about putting evidence-based practices into our starting point. Remember, that's our instructional platform. And that instructional platform should start with either an evidence-based intervention, or when that's not available, an evidence-based strategy. So our checklist in part 1 had you think about, well, what are the forms of evidence-based practices that you might want to use? And we defined evidence-based practices, check, and we identified the differences among the terms evidence-based interventions, evidence-based strategies, and promising practices, check. Now we also thought about evidence-based practices and where to locate different evidence-based practices. You can always look at different books and journals, but that's not always that fun or that easy. So instead, we can rely on lots of different internet resources. We looked at different websites where they have lists and they've rated different evidence-based practices. That's always a really good place to go to locate different evidence-based practices. And you can also rely on word of mouth, but as we talked about, you always have to think about who's telling you about the evidence-based practice and whether you trust the information that they're sharing. So when we have these evidence-based practices, we want to think about, well, what is the evidence? Is there evidence? Is there assessment data that shows results, maybe that showed improvement from before the intervention or compared to a group of students that did not receive the intervention? Has the evidence been replicated? That might have been done by multiple researchers with multiple groups of students and multiple times. And then you also have to think if when you're looking at the evidence, did the study itself or studies, have they taken place in a setting that is similar to the students that you're working with or a setting that's similar to your own and were the students similar to the ones that you've been working with? So in part 2 with our checklist, we thought about, well, where do you locate these evidence-based practices? We talked about identifying sources for locating such evidence-based practices and then determining the magnitude of the evidence. So that brings us back to our instructional platform. And within the instructional platform, kind of like as we think about figuring out those evidence-based practices, we may want to conduct a diagnostic to identify student strengths and weaknesses. Then we design the scope and sequence, and then we identify that instructional platform that's full of those interventions or strategies, or sometimes it's an intervention and strategy. So in part 3 of this module, we figured out, well, how do you determine the instructional platform? We talked about the role of a diagnostic, identifying the scope and sequence, which brings us back to a lot of the information we talked about in the first module. And then we talked about identifying those evidence-based practices to put into the instructional platform. So your application for this module is to evaluate a current instructional intervention or strategy that you are using. And I want you to dig deep and figure out what is the evidence. And is this something that you want to be using within your instructional platform within the DBI framework? Now, looking ahead, we have just finished Module 3, and now we're going to head into Module 4 and 5. And these two modules are going to tell us about how should we deliver the instruction that's within our instructional platform, and what other strategies might we want to put within our instructional platform to help students with learning difficulties. In Module 4, you're going to check out this article. It's about using evidence-based practices to build both conceptual and procedural knowledge. And this is going to talk about the use of multiple representations, which is an important component of Module 4. We will see you soon.